Hey, what's up, everyone? And once again, welcome back to Paper Mario The Thousand Year Door. Last time, we finished Chapter 7, defeated Magnus von Grapple 2.0, and also checked in with Bowser, who's still having a bit of a rough time. And in this episode, we need to find a way off the moon. But before we head to sub-level 2 to go back to that teleporter, we have not gone to sub-level 4 yet. So how about we go check out what's down here? Because this is an entire separate floor. Off to the left. Oh my god, here it is. Here it is. The princess's room. With her music playing and everything. Can Mario shower? No. But we found it. We found where she's being hidden. She was way in the depths. Way, way down in the depths of this place, which makes sense. They would want to keep her out of sight of everybody, but... God, just hearing that music kick in got my emotions running, dude. That was something. Also, Ms. Mouse, you're great, but I'm gonna have Goombella out for this. Let's head over to the right, because we know exactly what's through this door. Where are we?
You are Mario, are you not? It is pleasant to meet you. I am the main computer of this fortress. I am Tech. I must tell you something. That is why I brought you to this place. Princess Peach. I am so sorry. Most of my data was erased, and my main power unit was shut down. Now running on backup power with only cache memory, trying to stay operational. Mario. You know that Peach is not here, do you not? Please save Peach. Please. Please. Princess Peach is with Grotus in the Palace of Shadow. I had to tell you that. But backup power failing. Mario, use the teleporter room to get back to Rogueport. Teleporter room is on sublevel 2 of the fortress. I will release the room lock.
Peach is in the Palace of Shadow?
Please hurry. There is barely enough power left to activate the teleporter. I will cease all AI functions to send power to the teleporter for you.
But what'll happen to you?
When the power is all gone, I will cease to exist as an artificial consciousness, but if it will save Peach, I would gladly do this, because until I met Peach, I knew nothing of love. Do not worry about me. I am just a computer, just a machine. Mario, you must save Peach. I ask you, please, and tell her. you for me.
We understand, Tech.
So, hurry to the teleporter room now. Mario, save her. Tech system failure reported.
Mario, we have to save Peach for poor Tech, too.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, is right. That's my boy right there. I'm getting a little choked up over a computer, I'm not gonna lie. Alright, we gotta go. Tech has given us one last shot at getting out of here. Choose your destination, sub-level 2, please. Because we need to get back down to Rogueport. I guess if we had tried to go over to that room, it would have been locked. I guess that makes sense. You know, Magnus von Grapple, Grotus got defeated, so he's gonna be like, destroy everything, or whatever. It is not this room. It's not this room. I am lost, because of course I am. Why would I not be lost? Is it this one? It's gotta be this one. It's gotta be this room. It is this room. Alright, come on, turn it on. Get out of here. Back to Rogueport we go. Thank you, Tech.
Peach. Goodbye.
Am I going totally nuts, or did I hear something just now? I don't know, did you? Doesn't react whatsoever. Apparently, it doesn't work. Did he blow up? Oh, no. Oh, no.
Well, if it isn't Mario! Over here, son! You brought the crystal star back from the moon with you, didn't you? What? Talking to my good ear. The X-Naught Fortress was on the moon? Ah, yes. So Princess Peach was there too, I assume.
Well, she was, but the X-Naught boss took her and headed for the Thousand-Year Door.
Aha! Just a bit ago, I smelled some rank air and went to the Thousand-Year Door. I saw a suspicious fellow in a cape go through the door with Princess Peach.
But what? No way. Without the seventh crystal star, the doorway shouldn't open, though.
Believe me, I know, but I'm quite certain of it. I saw it with my own eyes. I have a very bad feeling about this. Very bad. Princess Peach is in danger. Time is short. We must go to the Thousand-Year Door and rescue the princess. I'll run ahead and meet you there. Don't dawdle. You must come immediately.
I mean, there are troubles available to us now. And we got an email, and we have the option to go do the troubles. RDM final issue. Issue 7, special final issue. Rogueport today. In a shocking series of events today, local authorities report that Zest T, age 55, delivered a left hook to the jaw of Gadabout Flavio, age 25, late this very afternoon. Our investigation has revealed that the cause of the feisty fisticuffs may have been Zesty's anger that a shipment of gourmet ingredients spoiled on the dock because Flavio had held up the dock crew with a marathon two-day tale of high seas adventure. While Flavio is recovering from temporary memory loss, Zesty has already been approached by a Glitzpit talent scout, Don Goombati.
I think the kid's got spunk. We'll take the world by storm, said Goombati.
Shop reporter, go! This week we have an explosive exclusive on the shop in Far Outpost, Northwind's Mart. It's so cold there that all of the merchandise is frozen to the counter. Just kidding. The smiling shop manager showed us a fascinating variety of goods as the sweet-faced little miss explained, "It's cold out, but I do my best to explode inside to explode inside shop to warm place up, da? So come on in." That's right, you're Russian. This place is big too, folks, so we haven't even seen all of it yet. Come on down and see it for yourself. Cooking for Rookies. This is the final installment of Cooking for Rookies. Just to make sure we leave you with a smile on your face, our last recipe will be for a couple's cake. Just simmer spicy soup for a few minutes, then drop in a snow bunny and presto. Before your very eyes, your mixture will congeal and take the form of a cake. Eat it with someone you love. Editor's note, this is it, dear readers, the final issue. We here at the RDM office have enjoyed every minute of our hard work to bring you the best news and features. May we meet again, perhaps sooner than you think. Wink, wink. Published by Rogueport Restoration Committee. Yeah, we're taking on the troubles. Look, man, I'm sorry, not sorry. You know, we got something. We got people who need our help. You know, people absolutely need our help in Rogueport. These are available after Chapter 7. It's got to be done. It's got to be done. What do we have? Gold Bob, delivery, please. I need you to take something to General White. Please come get it with all speed. Meet me in Poshley Heights. Yeah, we'll take on Gold Bob's trouble. And while we are here, how about we head up... No, I need Charles. How about we head up to this roof again and see if that last story is available to us from Grifty up here, because... I mean, we completed a chapter, so maybe he's got something more to tell us now, you know? It's possible. Hey, buddy. How you doing? How you going? What's going on? Good day to you, sir. Is there a tale you want to hear? The magical map, the last one. For a mere 5 coins, I can share with you the tale of the magical map. The heroes knew that the seal might not last forever, and they sought to make the crystal stars available to one who might need them. So before going to their individual dooms, they made a map to all the stars. And to prevent an evil force from misusing this map, they placed it in a box that could only be opened by the pure of heart. If there is another tale you wish to hear, just ask. So that is it. That is all of the tales. And of course, we already knew that, because that's what happened right at the beginning of the game. You know, when Peach opened the thingy. Now, the other thing that I want to do in Rogueport before we do this trouble... is I want to find Luigi. I don't know where he is, but he's got to be around here somewhere, because I imagine he's got another tale to tell us, and absolutely we're going to listen to him. But he's not down here, which makes sense. He's going to be hiding around here somewhere. It's probably like in the inn, maybe. I guess we'll find him. We'll figure it out. Yeah, I want to say he's in the inn. That just feels right to me. I don't know why. He's been on like a long journey, so maybe he's upstairs? He actually is! Okay!
Let's see, adventures. Oh, of course. Me, I'm done questing for now. Yep, I scaled Hatesong Tower the other day and rescued the fair Princess Eclair. That's one adventure I'm never gonna forget. Nope, it was just too exciting. It was just bonkers, bro. Wanna hear what happened? It's a pretty long story.
Absolutely, Luigi.
Hey, sounds good to me. Which part do you want to hear, bro?
The new one.
Well, like I said, it's a really long story, and this part is just crazy, but here goes. Hatesong Tower stands atop a jagged, unclimbable cliff beyond the northernmost sea. The winds whistle down the cliff, howling like banshees singing songs of hate. People say it's pretty much the scariest place in the world, and I had to go there. Blocking out the bone-chilling howls, I somehow managed to reach the tower's door. I was terrified, but the thoughts of Princess Eclair warmed my heart and gave me power. All of my companions felt the same way. They were with me to the bitter end. The door to the tower swung slowly open to reveal an inconceivable darkness. I tried to call out Princess Eclair's name, but I couldn't even breathe because, as I strained my eyes in the darkness, I saw the most terrifying beast of all. The Chestnut King himself appeared before me. He was monstrous and drooling. Puddles of toxic goo dripped from his mouth, melting the very ground at our feet. I couldn't stop shaking, but I gritted my teeth and faced the evil beast dead on. I dodged the king's fangs, jumped onto his chest, and gave him a hammer whack. My swing split the air and crashed dead center onto the Chestnut King's skull. Hope powered me, bro. I was going toe-to-toe with the king, and I was loving it. This is it, I thought. I can win this. I'll risk it all on my next blow. I gripped my hammer tight and waited for my moment. The tension stung me. Shwack! The ocean winds raged against the tower windows. With that sound as my call to battle, I advanced with no mercy in my heart. And then? And then? I beat him. I defeated the Chestnut King. An even worse beast came next, a nightmare thing, but I beat it too. I rescued Princess Eclair. It was all over. And then I came back to Rogueport and had a light lunch. And that's about it. Huh? You think there's more to the story than that? Not at all. That's it. That's the whole story of the quest for Princess Eclair. The end. But my adventures won't end here, bro. They'll never end.
Okay, Luigi. I believe you.
Hey, you! Remember me? It's me, Bluey!
Man, that last battle was hairy. You have no idea. I was burnt to a crisp, but I was actually kind of relieved, if you can believe that. If you want the whole story, you should just ask Luigi here. I didn't realize that was the same blooper that he had before, but apparently he just almost died. Okay, we need to go to Partially Heights for this trouble. Well, here we are. Of course, Bowser was just here as well. Is he still chilling over by the fountain? No. I guess he's done admiring the fountain's beauty. So, fun fact, there is no fast travel to Far Outpost. If we need to go there, we have to take the long road, which is just unfortunate. Hey, Gold Bob. So, Gonzalez, how did you enjoy your cannon ride, hmm? I'd like to go to the moon and look for some investment opportunities. But enough of that. I need you to take this to General White immediately. A package! An item Gold Bob asked you to deliver to General White. I think General White is back in Far Outpost now. It's a bit far, but you can handle it. Hey, as long as he's actually there and not chasing me around the world. Traveling back here sucks, purely for the fact that there's just a bunch of enemies. I had to run away, so we've lost a few coins. He's not in here. Huh? General White? He left this morning, Wapow! He said he was gonna see Cola Bartender in Rogueport or something? You are pulling my goddamn leg. He's in Rogueport? I was just there. Is he really doing another fetch quest? Or another... Also, where's the cannon? Hang on. Cannon will not be fired until day we have been waiting for comes. Cool, I'm going back to freaking Rogueport. I might have jinxed myself by saying, I hope he's just there. Because he's not going to be here, is he? He's not going to be in here. Oh my god, not you! I swear, I always end up talking to that guy. General White? Yeah, I spoke to him just a second ago, actually. We're old buddies, he and I. I've known him since he was a little snapper that would explode over any little thing. Then again, I was the kind of guy that would bonk people for smiling funny. Still, he turned out to be a fine bob-omb. Though he never cured that wanderlust. I'm pretty sure he said he was off to Glitzville next. I go back pretty far with the guy that runs the juice shop there, too. So give him my best. He's in the juice shop in Glitzville, isn't he? He's all the way up in the flippin' sky. Now, I already know he's not gonna be here. I'm not daft. I know that we're gonna have to go all over the freaking world. Just chasing after this guy, and then he's gonna end up back at Far Outpost. That's how it's gonna be, isn't it? That is exactly how this is gonna be. But let's see. Is he here? No. General White? He pounded 3 white chocolate coconut mochas and bolted. He dropped in every once in a while. Hey, and you know that lady in the black dress? I think General White has a thing for her. But that's just my gut talking there. She's darn cute after all. Guys come in for more than just the juice, I think. Hey, just between you and me, one of her admirers is Rawcock. Oh, now that I think of it, General White said he was going to Far Outpost soon. But first he had to meet Gold Bob. Or not meet him, or something like that. He went to Gold Bob. He went to Partially Heights. This trouble could have been entirely avoided if Gold Bob had just had just a sliver, just a tiny sliver of patience. That'd be it. That's all he needed. Just a teeny tiny. But he's a big hat-wearing rich man. He wants everyone to do everything for him. Gold Bob, if he's not here. Of course he's not. Ah, Gonzalez! General White was just here a moment ago. But you had the thing I wanted to give him. What a rotten bit of luck. He said he was headed back to Far Outpost. That General White is a fine bob-omb, but he does tend to wander. And once he's asleep, he's near impossible to wake. It's near impossible to wake him, don't you know? Oh, I know. I told him to stay out and awake, so get over to Far Outpost. Sorry about that. Cool! If he's not here, I am gonna be disappointed. Please be in your home, my guy. Please, you're asleep. He seems to be asleep. Yeah, wake him up. Yeah. Oh no. Okay. Not again. Still sound asleep. Oh no. No, no, no.
General White!
You are a pain in my ass. Okay, I know on the when we did the story-based thing about chasing him around the world, I was like, it's not that bad. It's not that bad. It's not that bad. That part is not that bad. But he does the same thing again for a trouble. Oh my lord. Don't laugh.
Hut! Hello, Mario. Do you need something? Hut! What? A delivery? From Gold Bob? You came all that way just to bring it to me? Well, thank you for that. I'll take it off your hands. Package. Yes, well delivered. So you'll go fetch your reward, I assume? Say hello to Gold Bob when you see him. Well then, perhaps I'll go check on my cannon. Yeah, that might be a good idea. Do you want to know the fun part?
We now have to go back to Poshley Heights to claim that reward, and then the next trouble is also in Poshley Heights. Gold Bob, please make this worth my while.
Did you find General White? I see. And he received it? Good. Thanks, Gonzalez. Here is your reward.
Nice. Isn't it episode 64 as well? You solved the trouble. Cool. Let's go get the next one. I realized that I said we have to go back to Poshley Heights for the next one. I don't actually think that's true. I think the last one is Poshley Heights. The next one is Far Outpost, so it's even worse. From Gob. I've lost my voice because of this stupid stuffy cold.
Yaboomski!
I want someone to bring me some honey candy.
Yapow!
Great for the throat, I hear. I think you can make it by combining cake mix and honey syrup. Yachow! I'll be waiting next to the snowman in Far Outpost. Yablammo!
Let's take it on. And I've already picked up the ingredients. You can get a honey syrup from just the general store here. And then you get the cake mix from the Pianta Parlor. So I've already picked those up to save us some time there. But I also wanted to show you that if we go back to the store, there is another Super Luigi book, Volume 4. So, yeah, I'm picking that up. And if there's a Volume 5... I'm gonna pick that up when it appears as well. Anyway, Far Outpost. Nope, not Far Outpost. I forgot. We actually have to make the thing. So, hi Zesty. How you doing?
Want me to cook something for you, Clumsy Crush-a-Lot?
Yes, please. Honey syrup and a cake mix, please. Then I'll cook up your honey syrup and cake mix. Yep. I'm gonna mix these up for you, so just wait a sec.
Sorry to keep you waiting. I'm not entirely sure you'll like this, but go on, take it, Stompy.
Honey candy. Replenishes 20 FP. That's not bad. Anytime you feel like it, feel free to bring me stuff to cook with. Yeah. For the amount we spent on those items, 20 FP for that? Definitely not bad. He said buy the snowman, right? So this guy?
Yeah.
That's terrible. Don't worry about it. Honey candy.
Oh, he seems excited. Ah, finally I can speak. Ya pow!
I had been exploding so much that I completely lost voice.
Ya bluey!
Thanks, ya crackety. Here's a token of my appreciation. Ya boom! 20 coins. Alright. Cool. Now, finally, for the last trouble. If there's one thing I hope they change in this game's remake, which, by the way, this game is getting a remake, I don't know if I've ever talked about that in the series, but that's a thing that's happening. I hope they make it so that you can select multiple troubles at once.
Toadia, I want to meet Luigi!
I must meet my darling Luigi. Come to the fountain in Poshley Heights for details.
Okay. I don't think Luigi's gonna wanna do that, but we'll see. We'll see. Back to Poshley Heights for the 50th time this episode.
I'm here, and you're right by the fountain, so is it you?
Hello, so you accepted my request for trouble help? I thought maybe it'd be Luigi. Oh well. So could you bring him here, maybe? I'm a huge, huge fan of his. I just have to meet him. And I want to give him a cake. I have to give him a cake. Okay, bring Luigi here. Got it? What if... Just hear me out. What if... Just hear me out. I can totally tell. I've never met him before, but I can absolutely tell. You're the real Luigi. I knew it. This is so cool. Oh my gosh, what should I say? I'm totally freaking out. I'm freaking out, Luigi. Oh no, what should I do? Oh, right, duh, the cake. The one I baked was a total loss, but Zesty did a great job on this one. Here you go, Mr. Luigi. Please take this. You got a choco cake. A cake made by Zesty replenishes 5 HP and 15 FP.
Hey, bro. Say, why are you dressed up like me?
Hey! Who do you think you are, you filthy imposter? Police!
What? I'm no imposter. I'm Luigi. Hey, say something, Mario.
Ew, he's so much like Luigi, it's creepy. He's trying to masquerade as Luigi to interrupt our special time together.
That's crazy. This is a nightmare, a bad dream. I won't believe it. Wake up!
Ah, no way. I know I wasn't supposed to see that. No way. Don't worry about it. Oh, thanks. Really, Luigi, you're so sweet. And thanks for coming today. I will always treasure these moments, always. So please, come and see me again, okay? You solved the trouble. All that. How was that a trouble? She was just being a pain. Oh my god. We're done. Back to Rogueport we go. That was painful. So that is all the currently available troubles. And I believe everything else we're able to do in this in-between section here, because, of course, we're kind of in a rush to go rescue the princess, but we just spent God knows how long helping out a bunch of other people, and sure enough, there's no more Super Luigi in here. So that is going to go ahead and do it for this episode of Paper Mario the Thousand Year Door. Also, I kept forgetting to read this. I think this updates every chapter. Ancient prophecy discovered. When the moon shines bright, the end will draw near. Excellent. Is there anything around the back? There is. Graffiti corner. What's going on tonight? Is the man in the moon freaking out or what? The starstruck astronomer. I should have been checking that every single time we came back here, but I kept forgetting. So, next time on Paper Mario the Thousand Year Door, we'll do a little bit of prep. I may cook some stuff. I haven't quite decided yet. Or we'll just raw dog it and we'll just go into chapter 8. And just see what we can do. Why am I here? I was looking for a bed. We'll see. I haven't decided quite how I want to do this yet. Maybe we'll heal. Heal? I mean, I guess that's what we're doing. Maybe we'll do some prep. Maybe we won't. We will see in the next one. If you guys enjoyed this video, this long, painful journey to do these troubles, please make sure to let me know by leaving a like. And let me know what you thought of it in the comments section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.